Hello, Gemini. Welcome to your 72 and you reading, where we are looking at what is taking place for your sign over the next 72 hours. You can watch this reading if you are a Gemini sun, moon, or rising, Gemini on the house cusp. If you have your sun in the third house or Venus in Gemini, you can watch this reading. I'm also going to include if you have your Mercury or Jupiter in Gemini, please feel free to tune in. Cross watchers are also welcome. Just keep in mind these are general forecasts and I'm focusing on Gemini. So the reading is tailored towards their sign. If you'd like to book a personal private tarot reading with me, for example, you can definitely do that. I do have openings available this month as well as next month. Feel free to check down in that description box. You'll find my website and scheduling page down there as well as up in the right-hand corner. Just click the eye in the sky. That will take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. For your reading today, we have two decks here, the Gilded, Reverie, Lenormand Expanded Edition. I'll be using this at the beginning of your reading and then we'll jump into the tarot cards. I am using the Fountain Tarot deck today by Roost Books, and both of these are listed down below for your convenience. For the sake of time, I'm going to kind of just move along here and keep it moving, and because Geminis don't really have the patience to wait around for explanations of things, so let's jump into the reading. What are the general messages and energies you have for Gemini over the next 72 hours, Spirit? What are the general messages and energies you have for Gemini over the next 72 hours? We have the Mountain. There's an obstacle here, a block. This is also Saturn's energy. Either you have to find a way around this obstacle or go back from whence you came. That's kind of the message with the Mountain here. Also, the cartomancy meaning is the Eight of Clubs, which is Sag's energy. All right, so someone could have blocked communication here. You could be dealing with a Sagittarius. And the number 21 or the 21st is coming up, so that could be an important date for you. Tell me. I think the 21st is coming up, yeah? Yeah, in a couple days, it'll be the 21st, so that might be an important date. Tell me more. We have the Key. There's an important piece of information you need. I feel like someone could be holding back information. You need to unlock something here, but in order to do that, you've got to get this important piece of information. There's a key, okay? But there's a mountain right in front of that key. So I'm not sure. It just feels like someone's blocking some important information that you need. We have Eight of Diamonds here. That's Virgo's energy. That's also Capricorn's energy. I keep hearing you need to find a workaround solution, or this could be very difficult because the Mountain is definitely a huge obstacle. Underneath the deck, we have the Garden. The Garden talks about something going public, something being made public. Think of public relations, marketing, communications, or an event here, or something is taking place outdoors. This could be quite literally a mountain here. Like a mountain is blocking something. So maybe this is a geographic feature of importance. So for someone out there, the dates, the 20th and the 21st are coming up for me. So let's jump into the tarot cards here. I'm going to kind of just place that card there. All right. What is happening for Gemini, Spirit, over the next 72 hours? I'm hearing 27. I heard this number 27 hours. Something about 27 hours. What's happening for Gemini over the next 72 hours, please? What is happening for the sign of Gemini over the next 72 hours? Show me. We have the Five of Coins. Taurus, someone is out in the cold. There could be radio silence. Someone could be ill. It could just be very, very cold. This looks like someone could be homeless here, or just there's a feeling of lack here, poverty consciousness. Tell me more. What's happening for Gemini? Yeah, you need some information here is what I feel. The Knight of Cups, the Lover. You could be dealing with a water sign, a Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. Someone wants to apologize. It looks like, I don't see this person taking action though. They're kind of just sitting with a bowl on their head on a waterfall. So this person is, you'd think that they would be going with the flow, but the feeling I get from this is someone that They're a person that feels likes experience like to feel to they idealize love. Okay, they idealize love, the experience of love, but reality and fantasy are two very different things. So someone is experiencing like a wake up call or a reality check, I guess, regarding this person or the situation, or this is you, Gemini. Tell me more. What is happening for Gemini over the next 72 hours? We have the Empress, Taurus, or Libra. We have the Emperor. You have a match here. This is a divine counterpart, so you are dealing with your Emperor, or if you're the Emperor, you're dealing with your Empress here. Yes, we do have a match, but someone is out in the cold here. Let's go in and clarify these cards. This could be your parents as well. Divine Feminine, Divine Masculine are here, but we do have an obstacle, okay? We have an obstacle here. Let's find out what that obstacle is. Clarify the Five of Coins. Why is Five of Coins here? Ace of Cups. There's a lot of love. Someone could be losing fluids here. I keep feeling like someone's out in the cold here. Usually with the Five of Pentacles, it means that someone has given up material possessions in order to grow spiritually. So at the very least, someone here is experiencing unconditional love. Maybe this is just their heart is, there's a lot of pain here, a lot of sadness, but at the same time, at least like there's some emotions. I don't know. Knight of Cups. Why is Knight of Cups here? That's an interesting message though. I'll have to think about that. Someone is definitely crying here. These are tears, real tears here. Tell me about the Knight of Cups. Seven of Swords. This lover here, or this water sign, they are deceiving people. They're cheating. They're lying. They're cheating. They're stealing. Yes, they're being strategic, but I really feel like someone has made someone cry here. Why is the Empress here? Eight of Cups. Gemini, I feel like that's your energy. I feel like you're walking away from this person. Tell me about the Emperor or Cross Watcher. You're walking away from this Gemini. Whoever's doing this. Cheating, lying, cheating, stealing, playing games. Three of Coins. This Emperor is fine with having a third party. Or this Emperor is someone that you work with, or you're the Emperor and you work with this Empress. This Empress is walking away. Of course, this could be someone you work with, or this person, I guess they are employed. They're employed. At least they have a job. I don't know. Why is Five of Coins, Ace of Cups here? I feel like there's a third party. That's what I feel. I'm just getting that. Why is Five of Pentacles, Ace of Cups here? Nine of Swords, Two of Swords. Someone's really going through it here and they don't know what to do. Why do I feel like this is exactly what this person, this is what they deserve? I don't know. That's what I feel like. Maybe this person deserves this. What they're getting is what they deserve. But it seems pretty harsh. Why is Nine of Cups, Seven of Swords here? Why is Nine of Cups, Seven of Swords here, please? Nine of Cups, Seven of Swords, please. Four of Wands. This has to do with a home or family situation, a living situation. This Nine of Cups here looks like they're partying a lot. They feel like it feels like this person is right at home. They feel very comfortable with the situation. Maybe a little too comfortable. Why is Empress, Eight of Cups here? Page of Wands. You're walking away, but you're sending a message, or they're walking away, but they're sending a message. And the Emperor's response is, Emperor, Three of Coins, please. Emperor, Three of Coins. Maybe I'll get back to them. I don't know. Nine of Cups, Stone of Swords, Four of Wands, please. Nine of Cups, Stone of Swords, Four of Wands, please. The Devil. Most person has an addiction. They have an attachment. It could be sex. It could be drugs. It could be alcohol. Or they're just really, really good at what they do, and that gives them leverage. Why is Empress, Eight of Cups, Page of Wands here? Empress, Eight of Cups, Page of Wands. Title card. Yeah, you're sending this person in a message or an email. Emperor, Three of Pentacles, Two of Coins. Emperor, Three of Coins. Sorry, Emperor, Three of Coins, Two of Pentacles, Queen of Swords. This person wants to be single, or they're widowed, divorced, or single, or they act like they are. Four of Swords, someone's healing. They're holding back, yeah. Someone ghosted someone here. Someone could be on a break in a relationship. This looks toxic, to be honest. And you met your match, Gemini. You met your match. That's for sure. I don't know who you are in this reading because your energy is here. So are you the Emperor? And then someone is kind of cold here. Maybe someone likes that though. Can I get one more on the Five of Pentacles, please? Five of Pentacles, Ace of Cups, Nine of Swords, Two of Swords. Someone is really scared about something here, but they don't know what to do. Tell me about this person that is scared and doesn't know what to do. The Sun. They're gonna find a solution. They'll figure it out. Someone is really playing games here, and like they love playing these games. This is a genuine, this Empress here, this is genuine. So you choose who you are in this reading. Underneath the deck, we have the Two of Wands. Yeah, you have free will. I wouldn't stick around for that, but it's your reading, Gemini. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. See you later.